What results can business users get from Power BI? You're about to see an oil industry Power BI dashboard built by Charl, Marais in about a month and in spite of facing many challenges. Watch this video till the end as you see Charl walk us through the dashboard, but also share his Power BI journey. And if you are ready to get results with Power BI, check out one of our training programs.
So what I did is a dashboard for a crude oil production facility. The company is in Nigeria, and the company's name is called Atabala. So this is how the dashboard looks, and we'll go into detail a bit later. Right, just some background. So crude oil is extracted from wells. The key products that they get out, there's a number of products, but the key ones obviously is the crude oil, which they measure in barrels. That's the BBL on the screen is what they use for barrels. Then they also get gas out of this process. They measure that in MCF. So one MCF is 1,000 cubic feet of gas. And then they get water as well out of the process, which they also measure in barrels. And then usually these production companies, they convert the gas volumes to what they call a BOE. It's a barrel of oil equivalent. And a barrel of oil equivalent is approximately 6 MCF of gas, depending on the energy level. So that's just a little bit of background on oil production. Usually a business would have different fields, and fields would consist of wells, one or more wells, and then the wells would consist of different batteries. Right, so if you look at kind of their need and from a problem perspective is that, you know, they have multiple geographically diverse production units, and daily production volumes are key to the business profitability. The existing production information, you know, according to them is slow, you know, inaccurate and fragmented, the kind of, you know, usual problems you get within a business. And it takes up quite a bit of management time to get to the information that they need on a daily basis. So what they need is, you know, accurate production data, and they need it available daily from a single source. And they want to go into detail, which you'll see in the dashboard, but also see it in a summarized way. Right, then I'm going to just move to the specific requirements for this dashboard. They wanted everything just on one page. They asked for 4 specific KPIs, which is production volume, then of the oil, as well as the gas in the 2 different units, and then also the water. And they wanted this compared to the day before and also to a 7-day average. They asked for a slicer only for the last 3 days, and then also a slicer for products, so that you can move between the different products. Then they wanted a 90-day line graph with the daily volume, as well as a 3-day average and a 7-day average volume. Then for the specific oil fields, wells and batteries, they wanted to be able to see the daily volumes and also compare that to the day before and the 7-day average. Okay, the data that I'm going to display is not real data. They actually wouldn't give me real data. They gave me some sample data that I used, And also, I went on to Excel and created quite a lot of data to be able to create this dashboard. So I'm not showing you real data when we get there. All right, the process that we went through, it was about a 6-week process. We started off with like weekly meetings. It was really tough. We both speak English, but we kind of speak a different English. So some tough meetings. We had it on Teams. Also, we didn't have great internet connection, and South Africa and Nigeria, we share something. We both have what we call load shedding. That's when the power goes off in a planned way, and during some of the meetings, we both had to deal with load shedding. We eventually communicated quite a bit on WhatsApp, which really worked well. It's just quicker and easier, and also because it's written, it worked pretty well. Yeah. So it took me about the first 2 weeks just to understand and clarify what they want, the requirements, just to get an understanding of the oil business and how it works. And then after that, I drafted a dashboard, which I presented after about 4 weeks. And then obviously made some changes to where we are now with a kind of a final dashboard. So for the dates, I've selected today's date, and the KPI, you can see the first one here at the top is for the crude oil for this date, 1.87 million barrels of oil. And then when you compare it to yesterday, there was a 3.5% growth. And then compared to the 7-day average, 0.7% lower. And then the same principle applies for these KPIs at the top. So here we have the gas in MCF, the gas in equivalent barrels, and then also the water. Right, then I'm going to move on to this line graph where you can see there's the daily volume, and then there's a 3-day average and also a 7-day average. They only showing the last 3 months here on the x-axis, and they asked for a slider here, so you can actually just zoom in and zoom out when you want to. At the moment, it's showing the volumes of crude oil. So if we want to go to the gas equivalent barrels, obviously you can just click there. Okay, so that's the line graph. I'm going to start here on the field just with a column graph. So they, in this case, we created data for 5 fields. So I'm going to start, I'm just going to click on this one. So you guys are familiar with this. Once you select this field, you can also see the KPIs for this specific field and the wells that makes up the field. And then also the batteries, there's just quite a number of them. So you have to scroll on them. Then when you click on yesterday, you can then see for the specific fields, the volumes for this column is the volume for today, and then the volume for yesterday, the variance and the variance percentage. And then the same principle applies for when you look at the 7-day average, comparing your volumes of today with a 7-day average and getting the variance percentages. And then the information for the wells and the batteries works with the same principle as I've showed you with the fields. So I'm not going to go further into that detail. Okay, then just some general feedback. Obviously, I was disappointed not to work with real data. But it was quite a challenge for me to create this kind of one page dashboard, and it allowed me to learn quite a few new things, which I'm grateful for. It was never explicitly said, but I think the manager who I worked with, his idea was just to get out of this PBIX file and then see if they can use that and connect it to the real data. So we haven't been in contact since I've finished this off. Maybe they come back, I'll see. And this is my contact information. And thank you so much for the opportunity. It's been really an interesting ride, which I enjoyed.
Well, that's great. And thanks so much for sharing. And hey, I'll say, if those don't get back, it's their loss. And maybe it's going to be the next oil company, because what you showed was pretty incredible. Great. So hey, thanks for all of that. So really enjoyed the presentation. But you did mention quite a few challenges, right? You talked about just starting with not being able to work with a real data set. They were giving you sample data. You had to create data for them. And then, of course, the language challenges and the power cuts. I want to understand what's going on in your mind, because I know sometimes, especially kind of working with a client can be like a bit of a dance, right? Or dating, something like that, sometimes there can be a lot of frustration kind of going on, can build up. How do you manage that? I mean, obviously you pulled off really incredible results, but how do you manage when things are not going well? How do you kind of manage your own mindset or the what's coming up for you inside?
I think, Avi, having kind of a difficult ride with challenges is what we say in golf is par for the course. I mean, it happens in every project. So, I mean, I haven't had projects that is just goes the way you think it would or you'd like it to be. So there's always challenges.
Yeah.
And then I try to focus on, I mean, what is there in this case? I really focused on what is there that I could get out of this, just for me personally. And I mean, yeah. I did learn quite a number of things in terms of the dashboard, and how to do it. And, just focusing on the positives. And I think also, you don't need to let the customer walk over you. There's ways in which you could, could say no to certain things and handle yourself in a certain way. And I think that is, being able to say no is also very important. Otherwise, sometimes you get into something that you really don't want and it goes into a very negative spiral.
Oh, love it. So folks, I hope you got the feeling this is years of wisdom that Charl just, kind of delivered in just a few minutes. And I'm so glad it's recorded, because I think we all need to just go back and listen to it. I'm just going to call out some of the things that he said. For one, he loved the golf analogy. He's like, yep, challenges are par for the course. And I know it sounds cliched about enjoying the journey, but so there's a line that I love, which is, if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans. And kind of that's the same thing. It was like, you go in with plans, but no plan survives first contact, right? And then you got to kind of roll with it. And so that's one, just not waiting for things to be perfect, right? Not expecting them in a way. But then the other part that Charl was talking about was that, hey, just focus on the positive. Like, what value can you get out of it? What value can you bring from this for yourself, for others around it? And so, of course, in our programs, we talk a lot about internal journey, because, again, that stuff is important. Getting a handle on that internal dialogue, that chatter, your saboteurs, will help you get better external results and kind of deliver better results for others. And so good for your business, good for your career. Charl, thanks so much. Really love that. And folks, we're going to be putting Charl's contact information on the chat as well, so that it's easier for you to click. Charles, thanks again.